First topic for this session we'll be seeing is what is cost of capital. Now, we're talking about the word funds. We are going as a one by one acquiring, investing, distribution and liquidity. We're starting with the first decision of finance, that is financing decision. We want funds now. Now, when you see this word funds, as I told, see only from an organization or a company point of view. Company want funds now. Now, one thing a company knows, okay, they want funds, acquiring stage we are in, but they'll only be able to get money when they give a minimum return to an investor, right? I'll only get money when the shareholder or investor gets minimum return as such. I come and ask you money, give me 10,000 rupees. Why will you give me 10,000? You put your 10,000 in a bank as well, right? Now, you see in which case you give you a maximum return, right? Now, normal psychology of an investor is what they'll only give you money when they come see the maximum return on the investment, right? I don't know how many you know about this Big Bazaar Profit Club, right? Big Bazaar Profit Club came with this card, okay? You have to give at one shot 10,000 rupees to them and you can do shopping for rupees 12,000, okay? But one time investment is 10,000 and this 10,000 is spread in months during the year. Means at one, and you can only shop for 1,000 rupees you can use out of the 10,000. Now, but at the end of the year, what happens? 2,000 you save. Now you see the normally psychology of an investor. People bought that card. You see the card did not went so good in the market, right? Now first of all, there were various drawbacks. Now people thought that if I invest my money here, I can invest the same money in a bank. I can put that money somewhere else. And these, see from a psychology of an investor, they thought that putting the 10,000 somewhere else gives you more return than blocking your money in a Big Bazaar. So the concept was completely different. It is more to do with shopping, how it is to do with investment. What's the psychology of an investor? They feel that investing their money is more profitable for them than blocking their money for a Big Bazaar Profit Club card. Now, see normal psychology of an investor. Whenever they give you money, they can put their money in a bank, they can open a FD. But why will they give the money to a company? If they feel that a company gives them a more return as such. So, the first step which we require is when we are finding out the funds as such, we know the funds we'll only get from the public is when we give them a minimum return. So first step as a finance manager is to find out this return expected by an investor. This return expected by an investor is called as a cost of capital. So what is cost of capital? Minimum return expected by an investor. Minimum return expected by investors so that he'll only give you money. One more thing, keep in mind, you're not the only organization in the market or in the world who's asking money from the public as such. There are 100 companies like you who want funds from the public. But why will the public give you money? They'll only give you money if they see a minimum return which they're expecting, which will give it to them. Right now, this is our first step as a finance manager involves is to find out this minimum return expected by an investor. So what is cost of capital? The rate of return that a firm must earn on the investments, you can say, with invest the money later on to maintain the market value and attract funds. As I told you, whatever you study, okay, in finance, see that the goal of finance is met. What is the goal of finance? Shareholders' value should increase. You're taking money, you're investing money, whatever you do, shareholders' value should increase at the end. Now, if you see, you can ask money from various sources, right? You can ask money through debenture, equity, preference share, retained earnings. So cost of capital is what? Finding out the rate of return on debenture, equity, preference shareholder, retained earnings, right? A firm should earn a minimum return as such. Otherwise, if the firm fails to earn this minimum return, what will happen? The market value of a share will fall. Similarly, overall the wealth of the shareholders will decrease. And what happened? As we discussed in the previous session, whatever you do, wealth of the shareholder should increase. And if you're not doing it, the wealth of the shareholder as a goal of finance will not be met over there. And one day your company has to wind up and go home. So whatever you do, be very careful. Shareholders' wealth is increasing at the end, whatever you are covering. And in this, we are saying that your minimum return should be given to whom? The various investors when we are asking them money in short. So what is cost of capital? Now various people came with various definitions. Like we have cost of capital is a rate of return the firm requires from investments in order to increase the value of the firm and the market place. There's one more definition. We have cost of capital is what the minimum required rate of earnings or the cutoff rate of capital expenditure. The cutoff rate, the minimum rate which I should get the people give me money now. And how do we find out this rate? We'll be seeing is under cost of capital.